Welcome to Math with Professor V. This is video lecture for section 2.6 for business calculus on applications, mathematics of finance. So we just went over logarithms in the previous lesson, and we're going to use logarithms and go back to our compound interest formulas and look at some more applications. First thing we're going to talk about is effective rate. So if R is the annual stated rate of interest and M is the number of compounding periods per year, then the effective rate of interest is, we write R sub E, that means effective rate, 1 plus R divided by M raised to the M minus 1. So basically, remember, when interest is compounded a certain number of times a year, be it monthly, quarterly, semi-annually, weekly, you start earning interest on the interest, right? So actually the earning is higher than simple interest. What the effective rate tells you is what that compound interest basically is equivalent to had you been given just a simple interest rate that was only compounded once a year, okay? It allows you to compare different interest rates that might be at different levels and also compounded different number of times a year to compare which one is giving you a better yield or worse, depending on what you're looking at. If the interest is compounded continuously at an annual stated rate of R, then the effective rate of interest is given by E raised to the R minus 1. So we use a different formula for compound, just like we use a different formula for compound interest. The annual rate is called the nominal rate, where the effective rate is how much interest you actually accumulate by the end of the year. Effective rate is sometimes called annual percentage rate, APR, which you've probably heard from credit card companies before, or annual percentage yield, APY. So here we're going to look at, find the effective rate corresponding to each nominal rate of interest. And for all these problems, let's just round everything to 3 decimal places, okay? So let's find the effective rate of interest for 6% compounded monthly. So 6% means R is equal to 0.06, and monthly means M, the number of times the interest compounded in a year, is 12. So my effective rate of interest, R sub E, is going to be 1 plus 0.06 divided by 12 raised to the 12 minus 1. So 1 plus 0.06 divided by 12 ends up being 1.005. Then we need to raise that to the 12th and then subtract 1. And you get about 0.0616778, so I'll just say 0.8 because we're rounding to 2 decimal places, so I gotta move this over twice, and this is 6.168%. Okay, so 6% compounded monthly comes out to 6.168%. Very good. Now let's look at 5% compounded continuously. So now the effective rate when we're dealing with continuously compounded interest is E to the R minus 1. So this would be E to the 0.05 minus 1. And then you should have that button ready to go on the calculator. E to the 0.05 is about 1.05127, and then minus 1, I get about 0.051271, blah, blah, blah. So rounding to 3 decimal places as a percent, this would be 5.127%. Okay, good. So those are the 2 different formulas for finding effective rate of interest. Moving on, next idea has to do with present value. So all you need to do is refer back to the compound interest formula that we looked at a couple lessons ago. So remember, it gave you A equals P times 1 plus R divided by M to the MT. So for some of these applications right now, we're going to be solving for P, the principal, Or P will represent the present value and A is going to be some future value. Okay, so just same formula, just we're changing up the way the problem is phrased or what we're solving for. So here's an example. Frank must make a balloon payment of $20,000 in 4 years. Find the present value of the payment if it includes annual interest of 6.5% compounded monthly. So I'm going to make the little list off to the side of all the variables, A, P, R, M, and T. Now this time the balloon payment of $20,000, that's happening in the future. That's happening in 4 years. So that's actually the final amount. And T time is 4 years. I need to find the present value of the payment means what's the present value of that $20,000 right now that he's going to have to pay back in 4 years. Now the interest rate, 6.5%, so that's 0.065. It's being compounded monthly, so M is 12. So here we go, $20,000 equals P times 1 plus 0.065 divided by 12 raised to the 12 times 4. And then just to not have any rounding error, I'm gonna talk you through what I'm doing in my calculator, but I don't clear it along the way. So you have 20,000 equals P times, I would do all of this stuff in here, 1 plus 0.065 divided by 12 comes out to 1.005416, and it keeps repeating, okay? And then that's going to be raised to the 48th power. And then we have 20,000 equals P times this number raised to the 48th is 1.29602, blah, blah, blah. So then P ends up being 20,000 divided by 1.29602, blah, blah, blah. I'm just not clearing the calculator along the way. 20,000 divided by that previous mess, and it's $15,431.86. So that's the present value of the 20K he's going to have to pay back in 4 years. Oh. Okay. Next example. Andre wishes to invest a $5,000 bonus check into a savings account that pays 6.3% interest. Find how many years it will take for the $5,000 to grow to at least $11,000 if interest is compounded first quarterly and then continuously. Let's see how long Andre's gonna have to leave that 5K in there to make it more than double. Okay, so for the first one, we're compounding quarterly, so we're gonna use our compound interest formula. So let's list the variables here. A, P, R, M, and T. So he wants it to turn into 11K, that's the final amount. Presently, he has a $5,000 bonus check. The interest rate is 0.063, that is nothing to scoff at. And M quarterly means 4 times a year. We're solving for T, we're solving for how long. Okay, so let's set this up. I hope things work out for Andre in his lifetime. 11,000 equals 5,000 P times 1 plus 0.063 divided by 4 raised to the 4T. Okay, first things first, divide by 5,000. You want to isolate your base. Divide by 5,000, divide by 5,000. 11,000 divided by 5,000 is just 2.2. equals, I'm going to leave this as 1 plus 0.063 divided by 4 because it's not going to come out to a nice decimal. 1 plus 0.063 divided by 4. I mean, it's 1.01575. Do we want to write all that out? Sure, I guess we can. It doesn't go on forever, so let's just do it. 1.01575, and then we still have exponent 4t. Oh no, how do I get t all by itself? We're going to need to take a logarithm of both sides, or how about a natural log, my favorite. So let's take the natural log of both sides. And remember, we do that so we can now use our log property and move that 4t to the front. So now I'm going to have ln 2.2 equals 4t times ln 1.01575. And then last thing, to get t all by itself, I'm going to need to divide by this 4 and ln 1.01575. So I can just say t is ln 2.2 divided by 4 times ln 1.01575. And I'll just round to 2 decimals, or let's do 3. It's not science class, so we don't have to worry about sig figs. Thank goodness. Those always stressed me out. But for you science majors, I'm sure it's probably natural to you now, huh? This comes out to about 12.613 years. You know what? If Andre doesn't need the 5K, leave it in there, I guess, huh? I don't know. Okay. What if it's compounded continuously? Will that save us some time? So now we're going to use a different formula. Remember, for continuously compounded interest, we use that PERT formula. This will actually be easier to work with. So A is 11,000, P is still 5,000, E to the 0.063 times T. The first step is the same. So we divide by 5,000. You always want to isolate the base. So divide by 5,000. And then we have 2.2 equals E to the 0.063 T. Next step. Yes, take the natural log of both sides. And this time, please take natural log, because natural log of E is just going to be 1. So all we're left with now is ln 2.2 equals 0.063 T. And then last thing, to get T by itself, divide ln 2.2 by 0.063. And then let's see. Ln 2.2 divided by 0.063, 12.515 years. Oh, it didn't even save that much time. How depressing. So continuously compounded versus quarterly. Oh, Andre, I'm sorry. Hope your 5K can grow faster somehow. Or maybe he doesn't really need it. So it's all a win for Andre. Anyways, hope you enjoyed this lesson, and give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already. Stay tuned. There's more video lectures coming your way for business calculus. If you need to review compound interest, then check out the rest of the videos in this playlist or also in the pre-calculus video lectures playlist. And if you need to review any algebra or other things, then I have videos on my YouTube channel. Just check out the playlist, or you can use the search feature to search within my video library. And I also have lots of content on Instagram, TikTok. So you can follow me there, Math with Professor V. I'll be back sooner than later. Thanks so much for your support, guys. Bye.